chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Hi, my name is Ringo Flats, or some of you might know me, Trace. I would just like to thank you personally for picking up my first album, A Ringo Flats Christmas. I know that it's been hard these last few years. I know that Christmas is just one of the few things, alongside illegal drugs such as marijuana, psilocybin mushrooms, acid, cocaine, crack cocaine, Mexican brown cocaine, heroin, crocodile, K2, meth, and ibuprofen that has allowed us to keep going and stay strong. And I have to say, congratulations, we've made it. My lawyer says that I am also legally obligated to state that although I have altered and rearranged many of these songs, I do not own a single one of them. And all rights go to their original creators. So with that out of the way, please sit back, kick your feet up, and get ready to join me on this hour-long journey of timeless Christmas and winter music. Thank you, and have a good night. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Prosperos Año y Felicidad. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Prosperos Año y Felicidad. wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. Shut up, wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom. I like to call this song, O Come, One Faithful. This next song is one of my favorite Christmas songs of all time. It's called Sleigh Ride.
Thank you.
I'm so sorry for that. I don't know what happened. Here's the actual sleigh ride.
Thank you. open up the bill. Wonderful holiday, not your normal average everyday.
Sounds like someone fell my old coral tree. SpongeBob, Patrick, why'd you do this to me?
The world feels like it's in lovely.
Go away before I harm you bodily.
This Christmas feels like the very first Christmas to me.
There'll be shopping, decorating,
and plenty of snow.
Hey, Patrick, who's that under the mistletoe?
What, who, me? Would you look at the time, I should go?
People seem a little more brotherly.
Here's a special something to you from me.
Even all the trash on Christmas, it smells so sweetly.
This Christmas feels like the very first Christmas to me.
La da 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 da.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you want? Can't you see that I'm busy?
Step outside, we've got something for you to see.
SpongeBob, take this stuff down immediately.
Chestnuts roasting and birds in the third degree.
Tonight things are as good as they seem to be.
A star on top will complete all the scenery.
This Christmas feels like the very first Christmas to me. This Christmas feels like the very first Christmas to me.
Well, guys, another Christmas is come and gone. I'd like to end this very special album with one of my favorite Christmas stories of all time. This story, it hails from the beautiful, beautiful land of Iceland. It's called The 13 Yule Lads, also known as the Icelandic Christmas folklore, which depicts mountain-dwelling characters and monsters who come to town during Christmas. The stories are directed at children and are used to scare them into good behavior. The folklore includes both mischievous pranksters who leave gifts during the night and monsters who eat disobedient children. The figures are depicted as living together as a family in a cave and include Grilla, a giantess, with an appetite for the flesh of mischievous children, whom she cooks in a large pot. Her husband, Lepluit, is lazy and mostly stays at home in their cave. The Yule Cat is a huge and vicious cat who lurks about the snowy countryside during Christmas time and eats people who have not received any new clothes to wear before Christmas. And now my favorite part, the Yule Lads. The Yule Lads are the sons of Grilla and Lepluit. They are a group of 13 mischievous pranksters who steal from or harass the population and all have descriptive names that convey their favorite way of harassing. They come to town one by one during the last 13 nights before Yule, aka Christmas. They leave small gifts and shoes that children have placed on windowsills, but if the child has been disobedient, they instead leave a rotten potato in the shoe. So, and with more description of the Yule Lads, here we go. First off, there's Sheep Coat Claude, who harasses sheep but is impaired by his stiff peg legs. Then there's Gully Gawk. He hides in gullies, waiting for an opportunity to sneak into the cowshed and steal milk. Then there's Stubby. He is abnormally short. He steals pans to eat the crust left on them. Then there's Spoon Licker. He steals and licks wooden spoons. He is extremely thin due to malnutrition. Then there's Pot Scraper. He steals leftovers from pots. Then there's Bowl Licker. He hides under beds waiting for someone to put down their esker, which is a type of bowl with a lid used instead of dishes, which he then steals. Then there's Door Slammer. He likes to slam doors, especially during the night, waking people up. Then there's Skier Gobbler. He has a great affinity for skier, which is like an Icelandic yogurt. There's Sausage Swiper. He hides in the rafters and snatches sausages that are being smoked. There's Window Peeper, a snoop who looks through windows in search of things to steal. There's Doorway Sniffer, who has an abnormally large nose and an acute sense of smell, which he uses to locate leaf bread, also known as Laufbrood. There's Meat Hook, who uses a hook to steal meat. And then finally, on Christmas Eve, there's Candle Stealer, who follows children in order to steal their candles, which were once made of tallow and thus edible. The purpose of this is unknown, but some more facts about Iceland and Christmas is that in 1998, I want to say, they did a poll and found out that 50% of the population of Iceland believed in elves. Like, really believed in elves. And, yeah, that just makes me glad I live in America. You shouldn't have picked up this album. It's a mistake that you're here. It's a mistake that we're all here. And your parents know it. But, in the end, you know, you just gotta remember that Christmas is a time to rejoice with people. And, you know, just have a fun time. Just have a good time, you know? Anyway, Merry Christmas, I guess.